So one of the big impediments to coral reef recovery after a disturbance event is the survival of those really small coral larvae that are the early life history stages right after coral spawning. So in nature, less than 1 in 1,000 or maybe even 1 in 100,000 will actually survive to adulthood. And so if we're going to use coral seeding for reef restoration in the future, we really need to find ways to improve those survival rates of the corals that are put out into the field so that they can overcome that, what we're calling a bottleneck in the recovery process. One of the things that we're trying to better understand is what drives coral survival in that first year of life and how that differs amongst environments and amongst species. So we are aiming to do a large field deployment where we deploy these corals across multiple environments, across gradients and latitudes and inshore to offshore gradients, to really understand how those gradients interact with more fine scale processes on each reef to drive the survival of those larvae.
The mortality rate is really high because when they're so small, predation rate is really high, so there's a lot of fish that might accidentally graze them off the reef when they are just having little bites of something around the reef, but then they accidentally graze off these recruits. And then they also get very easily overgrown by all sorts of other macroalgae that grow around them, or by crustose, coralline algae. Because they're just not very big, they're not very competitive, and only when they reach a bigger size, they start to be able to compete with all these external drivers. We try to look at to assist them in that very first life stage by all sorts of measures, so by creative engineering solutions or by more biological environmental solutions.
So the field work that we're undertaking now is really aimed at trying to understand the who, the what, and the where of coral deployment and coral seeding interventions. So this will allow us to optimize the coral species and the coral devices that we're using to fit the environment that is receiving those corals to basically give us the best bang for our buck with the restoration that we're attempting. Well, really, we only have one chance a year to do the coral spawning work because they spawn by the lunar cycle once a year in their mass spawning event. And so that keeps us going through the long and late nights. And 14 nights after the full moon, we're still here spawning. But that keeps us motivated and energized. And because we feel that there's time pressure. Global warming is happening. The reef is experiencing disturbance events frequently. And we need to find solutions quickly so that we can address this problem.